bum 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 bum.
How to shop for male enhancement products. This is a subject I've needed to do for quite some time. All right, this is not a promo for any particular product nor ingredient. I just want to give you an idea of what ingredients to look for and what those ingredients may or may not do. And here we go. All right, when you go looking for a male enhancement product, you want to look at three different types of groups. All right, you have a couple of different groups here, which is the hormone effectors, and these items may be part of other groups too, but primarily hormone effectors, long jack, horny goatweed, yohimbe, smilax, tribulus, and DHEA. Now, by hormone effectors, what we're trying to imply is they may affect libido, how you think. Are you in the mood, so to say? They're not circulatory. They try to get you motivated. That's about the kindest word I could actually put in regards to it. Then number two, you have circulation effectors. Arginine, vitamin E, blood thinning agents, citrulline, AKG, ginkgo biloba. Now what this is for, and some individuals just have poor circulation and they need a little bit of greasing of that circulatory system, so to say, to get the blood flowing. And that's what's called your circulation effectors. However, now we'll go to our third group. There's a problem with circulation effectors. What may affect that blood flow into certain parts of the body may result in the blood flow going out just as fast. Think of it like you have a bicycle pump and you're trying to pump up your tire being a metaphor for you know what. You're trying to pump up your tire, but there's a hole in it. So you're pumping air into it, but the air is going out just as fast as it's going in. Henceforth, the disadvantage of circulation effectors if there's nothing stopping the circulation in a certain area. Now we go to group number three, and we call the possible cyclic GMP, otherwise CGMP. I don't want to get too technical, but just give you an idea of what's called PDE5 inhibitors. Now, if these are this, so you got your circulation going, but you got that hole in the tire. Think of your PDE5 inhibitors as putting a patch on that hole in the tire. So what happens is the blood goes in to certain member parts of the body, but blood doesn't come back out right away. Henceforth, things fill up pretty fast. So often you'll find these PDE5 inhibitors in things which help with circulation. However, these two, the patch on the tire and the air pump, so to say, are still not going to impact libido. I mean, it may cause certain parts of your body to extend, and that may, in the end, impact libido, but they're not going to affect your hormone system. All right, so when you go shopping for a male enhancement product, you have to ask yourself the question, am I really looking for libido? Am I just looking for circulation to get things going? Or my problem is I'm really healthy and I got everything going for me, but blood's leaving as fast as it's going in. So what the heck? Another popular class of what's called these PDE5 inhibitors, you may notice a lot of your prescription drugs, such as Viagra, Cialis, Levitra, and Fendra, which I've barely even heard of. Very cheap to make. In fact, the problem with them being so cheap to make is often when you go to buy something from unscrupulous sources, they'll be spiked with counterfeit forms of this medication, which would be problematic to people on a lot of prescription drugs. Now keep in mind too, you have your three groups. No product in these three groups, whether it be Icarin, Pepervine from Poppy, pomegranate juice, or basically clerodendron, are innocent on their own. They're not inert. They will interact with certain medications. So you really got to look at basically talking to your doctor in regards to this. And also too, keep in mind, even though these things may be under hormone circulation or inhibitors, a lot of these are under pilot study. They haven't had a really good clinical trial to validate whether they work in all cases or not. So keep that in mind. All right, now we go to our fourth note. So now you get an idea what to look for. Look for libido, circulation, or PDE5 inhibitors. What you want to do when you go to look, buy a male enhancement product is try to ignore what's called proprietary formulas. In most cases, there are exceptions, it's useless. Proprietary formula means nothing. Doesn't mean it's been studied. You could probably get some sort of a patent on it, so to say, but it doesn't mean anything unless that says that proprietary formula itself was studied. The other caveat is this, and it's what's called fairy dusting. And fairy dusting is you could take all these ingredients. Say I want to put long jack, horny goatweed, yohimbe, arginine, vitamin E, and then the carom, which is a form of horny goatweed. I want to put them all in the same product to make it look super powerful. The problem is when you fairy dust a product, you're just making the label look good. You're not actually using any clinical amounts, meaning a little bit of everything will get you nothing. So be wary of fairy dusted products. Always see if they have at least close the clinical amounts or the amounts that were used in clinical trials to get the impact or libido or enhancement impact they were looking for. All right, also too, don't buy from a P.O. box. Know your suppliers. If you go to check out who owns a domain name or website and they're masked, chances are if you're buying something online, something as important as this that could have interactions that could be dramatic, then basically you're just saying, you're playing the kids game, I'll close my eyes and open my mouth and see what happens. Know your sources. See how long they've been in business. See if they are accountable or if they put themselves in front of the company because they believe in the product. People that hide behind P.O. boxes, mail order and stuff like that, they're just selling from the trunk. And they know you don't care, you just want cheap. All right, prepare your diet. Before you even have to go any of these directions, look at your diet. If your diet sucks, that's gonna be problematic. Not a good enough amount of essential fatty acids, minerals like zinc and things like that, which help the libido naturally. Always look at your diet. When in doubt, you know what? Don't know what a good diet is? Go back to the way we used to eat before the 1950s and 1940s and so on and so forth. The diet of your ancestors is actually pretty darn good. Check your medications. Again, as I said, these are not inert substances. So always, don't be afraid to go to your doctor. Your doctor gets trained too over time also, and he may be aware of how AKG may interact with the blood pressure medication. Be open about it. Trust me, doctors get concerned about getting in trouble because the patients are afraid to tell them what they're actually taking. Honesty is a better policy. And also too, when you get through all this, I'm gonna shut comments off, but however, if you have any questions, feel free to email me. Again, know your three groups: libido enhancers, circulation effectors, and PDE5 inhibitors. When you go to turn the back of the label over and you see those ingredients, know what they are, make sure they're in clinical amounts, and now you know how to shop without having to ask anybody that you don't know any questions you may feel awkward about. Ralph Turchiano, signing off once again. Thank you.